Overcomers of the flesh may receive greater reward slash responsibility. What's interesting to note, we talked about there are three enemies of the Christian: the world, our own flesh, and the devil. According to the book of 1 John, just when the second that we trust Jesus Christ as our Savior, we've already overcome the world and we've already overcome the devil. Neither one of those can touch us. Now, we have to overcome our flesh. We have to die to ourselves daily. That's the walking of sanctification. Some Christians will do better than others at that. This is one of the things that's not commonly talked about. But those Christians that overcome their flesh and they do greater works. I know it's crazy, but you read Ephesians 2. We were created for good works. We weren't just saved just to say, hey, I'm saved. Cool, right? We were created and God prepared works for us beforehand that we are to walk in them. Whatever that looks like, I don't know. Is it to greet people when they're walking into church? Is that a work that God prepared beforehand for you? Maybe. That's just one of those things you got to decide between you and God. But what's crazy is some Christians will be overcome by their flesh. They won't conquer their flesh. I don't think they'll lose their salvation. I think that once you trust Jesus Christ as your Savior, you're justified, you're deemed not guilty. He doesn't try people two times. There's no double jeopardy. But there will be some Christians, carnal Christians, who are overcome in their flesh, and they won't receive as much reward in the coming kingdom. I know that's kind of a crazy thought, but that's scriptural. And what's kind of crazy is we don't get like rewards just to go around the millennial kingdom saying, hey, look at my crowns. Hey, look at my rewards. In fact, what I put here is kind of an emphasis there. The more rewards you get, the more responsibility you're going to get in the kingdom. Look at this life now as kind of the preseason game leading up to the real Super Bowl. Okay, Jesus over and over again, the scripture says, he who is good with this in this life, I will give them this in this life. We got to be really good with the stewardship things that he's given us here, which is preparing us for later.
And if you think about that, like my job is pretty simple. What I do, you know, I make smoothies, you know, I kind of run a little smoothie shop and that's what we do. So what I do is not very hard, but I try my best to be extremely faithful with just that little bit that I have. Like there's no way I could go run a multi-million dollar company. I don't have the skill set to do that. But I do know that in my little tiny brain and in my small little intellect, you know, I'm trying to be as faithful as I can over that little bitty shop, because I know once I'm glorified in the millennial kingdom, intellect and the gifts and the talents that I've received right now are just training me for that glorified brain. So after you get glorified, after the rapture, you're going to have that immortal, eternal body, and you're going to have a glorified brain. And your intellect, your capacity will be so much greater than it is now, and everybody's going to be pretty much on the even playing field. So if you think about it, how will he sort out who has what responsibility in his kingdom for 1,000 years? It was the people that were faithful over those little things they had back in their church age, right? Does that make sense? You know, that's kind of how I think of it. Like, even if it's just counting my money at the end of the night, I'm so, like, tedious about it, and I want to make sure everything comes down to the right penny because I'm trying to be faithful to Jesus. And I know that sounds silly, and that's not a whole lot, but just those little things, I'm trying to be faithful. So I'm showing them, okay, I'm ready to work in your kingdom because I know in the kingdom I'm going to have a much bigger brain, much bigger capacity to work. So,
and we've said that before. That's one of the things that revolutionized my walk in Christ, was when I realized I don't work for my boss. And don't get me wrong, I do work for my boss, right? I am subject to my higher authority, but ultimately who we work for is Jesus, right? Ultimately, when I'm sitting on the clock, every minute that I'm giving account to, I'm giving an account to the King, right? Not to my boss. So, yeah, it's kind of that walking that fine line of, are we trying to force this? So like with us in the smoothie shop, you know, we're always looking for an in. You know, we're always looking for get a conversation started about spiritual things, about it's stuff going on in the world. We're always looking for that in. So that's kind of what we pray for. We pray for divine appointments, you know. God just start to give us an in. Versus like the old T. Hood, Chuck, and Derrik, sometimes we would just be pretty bold and just, you know, go straight at it. Which there's, you know, there's a time and a place for that. But if it's not the Spirit who's preparing this heart, it's not the Spirit who's preparing this person, you're kind of just doing it on your own and kind of doing it on your own power. So it's important to kind of walk not too fast and not too slow. Always walking in step with the Spirit. That's kind of the hard part of sanctification.
Real quick, Parable of the Talents, Matthew 25 says, well done, good and faithful servant. You were faithful over a few things. I'll make you ruler over many things. So that's kind of what Tito's getting at with the smoothie shop. It may seem small, but if you're faithful over what God gives you, then your reward is great.
God gives you a lemonade stand. Make the best lemonade you can.